and appeased the Lord. But then, a few verses later, this is what happened. The sons of Eli were worthless men. How? How come? They did not know the Lord. How can the priest and the sons who were priests describe us worthless men? Describe us they did not know the Lord. Here's the thing. 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 22. Eli was very old. He heard all the his sons were doing to all Israel and how they lay with the women who served at the doorway of the tent meeting. The Bible tells us Eli, when he was very old, then and only then did he learn about what he saw in his vision. So what was Eli doing? Perhaps he was so busy. He was so busy doing the ministry, he neglected his own children. He was so busy preparing the career of his children that he neglected the character, the foundation of knowing God. Very sad. In the Bible tells us, God made Eli responsible. He makes the father responsible. Look at 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 12. In that day, I will carry out against Eli all that I've spoken concerning his house from beginning to end. I told him about to judge his house forever for the iniquity which he knew. In other words, God made Eli responsible, and he's going to judge Eli and his children. Because his sons were the first unborn sons, and he did not rebuke them. If you continue reading the Bible, you will discover the consequences of failure to do God's assignment has immediate consequences and long-term consequences. What can we learn? You may not be able to change your ancestors, but you can certainly influence them. You can impact them, and you can influence the future.
It is never too late to discover.